No.
Heine King? So one of Johnny's road buddies wants to call Johnny Heine King.
Do you think that's
appropriate?
Well, I mean, is it due
does
to
that
his
mean
proclivity,
he wants
to I can't even say the word proclivities for Heineken?
Well, that or he likes to show his Heine.
Oh, his Heine. His Heine King. Maybe that was inappropriate, Dave.
All right, so that was probably a little inappropriate. Now, I believe it's Heineken. I believe that's the right answer, Heineken. So this is the young Chris Fangre. And Chris has been coming up. He spent a few months in Philippines, but he's a hardworking kid, too. I mean, he works 50 hours a week. He's, you know, but he loves pool, and he's, you know, if he gets things going. Hi, guys. How's it going? So when he gets things going, he really has a flashy game. And he would really attract somebody like you, Melissa. I mean, he...
Well, I don't know what that means.
Well, what that means is, you know, you would be, you know, very
attracted
impressed with his game.
I was going to say, I mean, he's kind of 12 years old. I'm not...
you're not a cradle
robber. Not that much of a cougar yet. No. But they both... I know Johnny Kang is a very fast-paced player. And this... Chris seems to be running around the table.
Yeah.
So this might be a very quick match.
It will be. I don't think it'll slow down much at all, especially if they're both breaking good. But this table, that's what the big issue has been with this table, is it's not breaking wide open. There's like they're breaking and then coming back together kind of thing going
all
on.
All right.
There.
So maybe it calls for not a soft break, but just kind of maybe a modified, not quite so hard break is what you're saying.
Yeah, they're going to have to figure out the speed of the break. Absolutely.
I don't know. I was watching the Art Garcia match with Oscar earlier, and Art Garcia was crushing the balls.
He was hitting them hard.
And getting a great spread, but never really getting an initial shot. Like he'd drop three balls, but not necessarily have a good shot on the one—a forced bank or a push out, things like that. It was kind of tough.
So it's hard to control the cue ball with this break. So there, people are having to alter the speed of the break in order to get something going in, right? So let's see what we got here. So Chris is breaking from the same spot. Everybody else is breaking from on this table. And he broke the one straight in and hung the nine up. Hey, I don't
Let
know.
Me tell
this is
you,
a pretty nice little
this
start.
This is wired. This is pretty much wired. Yeah, the nine ball is
you
hanging.
Sure?
All he's got to do is just, yeah, I mean, the two and the eight aren't frozen together, but if you can get the eight past the seven, I mean, I'm looking at it. It's if he hits it correctly.
So the basic thing here is just to kind of control the cue ball.
You
right?
Basically, it's like you're playing. It's like you're playing the two ball if the eight and the nine aren't there. That's all you
got
to do.
I mean,
just cut those balls in.
Well, what you're saying, though, he has to slice the two to the corner.
Correct.
He can't hit it straight.
Correct.
Right?
Correct.
So he's cutting that deuce. So anytime you're cutting a ball, stuff can happen.
Absolutely.
Yeah. But it looks good from our side,
it
for
sure.
It sure
does.
But yeah, he has to hit the edge of that ball. If he cuts it thick, this eight ball could veer off and miss the nine, right?
That is absolutely correct. The
but
good news is
happen.
It's tough for the eight ball to hit the seven. He'd actually have to really overcut the two in order to drive the two into the eight.
And plus the five ball's blocking the corner, so his chances of scratching really become smaller too. Oh, he hit it great. Yeah, he hit it perfect. Yeah. Remember when you had eyes like that?
I still have eyes like that.
Or your eyes. every time I jump into a karaoke song.
That from?
Isn't that from 007?
Oh, it is. It's a little James Bond action.
Uh-oh, we got trouble in the back of me.
Peanut gallery.
All right, so now it's Johnny's chance. And Johnny, he breaks the balls ferociously.
He crushes them a ton, too.
He is a madman with that break.
You guys want to see somebody hit the balls hard. Get ready.
Right here.
I'd love to break like this one time.
Oh.
Oh, then he goes with the soft break. He just made us all look bad right there. Daniel turned around and said, monster break coming. And Johnny used this just the single arm, like, I'm just going
to. Nobody told him he had to break hard on this table. So he's probably, no, he's probably been playing on the other tables where that break is working. But on this table, you got to crush him.
Except he didn't make a ball.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Yeah, you got to crush him over here. But on those other tables, the pockets are bigger. I think you can hit it that speed, and it's perfect.
He made us look bad, though.
He did make us look bad.
I said he was going to crush the balls. And
should we have call a timeout?
We should. We should.
How dare you, Johnny?
Johnny, seriously.
So, okay, so he's got the one ball here. He's going to slice it in, but what is he going to turn it in, or is he going to just play it a little bit?
I'm going to turn it in because I'm actually going to try and get position for that two in the side pocket. So I'm going to try and.
He's really lengthening out on the shot. So
it's hard to turn it in like that. So he's just going to go back and forth like this then.
He's turning, I think. Yeah, he's going back. Yeah, he tried to do. He hit it nice. Look at
that.
It really released off that second rail, didn't it? I mean, it got by the seven and everything. That was a great shot.
I would have dug in a little bit, used a little bit of draw, and actually just tried to come one rail out between the four and the seven and play the two in the opposite side pocket.
Yeah, yeah. So you could draw out. You draw back over for the three here. You don't want to be straight in.
Don't want to be on that rail.
I think he got straight in. Yeah. So getting straight in on this ball makes this out a little bit more complicated. So now he's thinking about taking the four in the corner. Maybe he's got to draw it back out for the four in the side. I don't know. He's really close to the rail. That makes the shot even that much more difficult.
So
what would you do? You just go forward,
I'm
right?
I'm actually draw it back. And if he gets back to where he's at, he can play the play
well,
it in this
jacked
corner.
Up a little bit. Okay. See how nice and level he's staying, though? Very, very nice. Oh,
if he
excellent.
Gets real good, he can play
beautiful
the side
strike,
like that.
Strike. But I tell Absolutely. You what, he got a little bit too much.
Not a problem.
Not a problem?
Not
oh, that
problem.
Nine ball's not a problem? I mean, he's got to find a small spot there.
Well, he's not going to go in between the five and the nine. He's going to go in between the eight and the nine.
Oh, can he beat the nine?
Yeah, he can beat the nine.
Oh, okay. All right. Well, then he's at no problem. Oh, yeah. Got plenty of room
Oh,
over
with
there.
The inside and everything. Ooh. Look at that.
Oh, yeah.
Most people will draw that with outside, and the ball's going to take off, maybe get hidden behind the eight, you know?
Not him. Chris, he's got
I'm
a little.
I'm impressed.
Yeah. Hey, stop. No, that was a very nice shot. Very nice.
It was a great shot. I liked it. But now he is short hooked, which is something I'm experienced in.
Yeah, but look what he has. He has an extension.
An extension. I use the bridge. Being a WBBA player, I'm very familiar with it, very comfortable with it.
Sure, sure.
I'm not so comfortable with the extender here.
Yeah.
Look at it. Gets the draw and everything.
He's going to keep it out because he came too far.
Absolutely. He's laughing.
He might
He's
just
like,
keep
oh,
that extension forever. So he's just going to come out one rail. Try to get straight in on the seven so he doesn't have to move like he is, but he's not going to get straight in.
No, but here's where he's going to try and...
Well, he loves spinning the ball,
yeah,
remember?
Yeah, go straight down. Straight down table. A little bit. And then now he's going to play with the outside.
Oh, he loves that outside.
Come out between the eight and the nine here.
He's going to dig in here, right? He's going to dig in.
You don't want to dig in too much. You don't want to run into the eight ball.
Oh, yeah. He just wants...
No, I just wondered if that's going out. Where I get to
you know you're on camera now, right, Brooke?
Well, you know, as... Oh, hi, Brooke. How are you? Okay, let's see how it spins this ball. Oh, see, now that's our chance. Oh, came out nicely.
He gave him the little hand wave, the little,
yeah.
Sorry, I didn't mean to do
yeah,
that.
Yeah, but I'll take it.
But
every
everything
day
turned
of the
out
week.
Perfectly.
I think he had a lot this tournament off those rails. They're a little bouncy.
They
did you win your last bouncy. Match, Brooke?
I did win my last match.
Congratulations.
Oh, there
Thank
it is,
you.
Brooke.
I made two
bringing
very
in a
nice
W.
Combos. Combo Brooke.
Oh.
Combo Bro.
There we are. A new nickname has been formed.
No.
Shoot for the dough, Brooke. No.
Now that's stacked.
So right now it's 2-0, Chris. And
Fangre.
Oh, it has a little. Yeah. Hey.
You know, and he speaks fluent Tagalog.
Seriously.
Oh, yeah. He's a superstar. The kid is.
We'll let Brooke say that again. Fun fan fact.
Oh, Chris speaks fluent Tagalog.
Oh, fluent.
Do we know what nationality he is?
He is.
Not Filipino.
He isn't?
Not Filipino.
I thought he was part Filipino.
No, his parents raised him there, but he's not.
Oh, I did not know that. Huh. Interesting. Oh, you know, he squared up on that break, and it cost him. You got to hit that break with a little bit of an angle into the one rather than hitting it on the front like that, right?
Yeah, he came out of it smelling like a rose, though.
Yeah.
Because he did not leave.
Yep.
He could have
right
left
now.
Johnny straight in and instead.
Uh-oh.
I think they're right. Just calling my name right now.
Oh, Melissa's playing Santo Sambajon Jr. I love it. All right. Hey. Have fun, man. All right, so you did the right thing there. Johnny's got to push out. He's got nothing.
And he didn't leave him much.
No, but what Chris is probably going to be thinking about here is he might be slicing the one over to the side rail here to play the one to the bottom.
Under the.
If he can beat the four. If he can't, he's stuck. I think he might give the shot back, tell you the truth.
The safety's
like
tough. The shot's tough. There's not a lot going on.
Yeah. I mean, he might just play so slow to try to put the cue ball underneath the three ball.
Behind the three or the
right.
Four, yeah.
I mean, it just doesn't look good at all. But he's taking it. And he's got something in mind.
He's primed.
Oh, wow. You know what? That was a really well-played shot, but it's still not good enough. I mean, he left him a full ball. And when Johnny's got a full ball. See, now, Johnny Kang, he started using this extension on his cue, so he has a longer cue now. He likes the extra weight in the back of the cue. And there's been a lot of the pros that have went to this. They feel like
Shane,
it balances them out.
Of course, Earl started it, and then mm-hmm. Shane took it and ran with it. Wow.
That was an excellent shot. So what we're looking at here is a two-rail kick. I mean, what else you got? You don't have anything
else,
right?
Yeah, you
got
to come behind.
So he's stuck behind the six.
Looks like if he hits it firm enough, he can stick it behind the seven. But you got to hit it real pure on that one ball.
Yeah, and you got to decide if you're going to turn it with outside English or center ball.
Or to come into it clean, yeah.
And I think this is a center ball hit where you're trying to hit the one towards the side pocket.
And hold the cue ball behind the seven.
Exactly, or the deuce, whichever one, hopefully.
And hopefully send the one ball down to the bottom rail or down behind.
Yeah, it looks like that's where he's going. He's going, looks like center ball. Yep. Oh, he hit it beautifully.
Oh, that was perfect. Mike, it
a little hard, a little firm. But still, well placed. Man, that's nice.
That's exactly what we said.
I love it when they listen to us. I mean, who was that
it's
other
plan
guy?
Plan coming together.
Yeah.
He's only hooked by a little bit, though. It looks like he can masse around this.
He's jumping. If he jumps this, he's gonna hit it about a half ball, and he's gonna play the cue ball towards the nine, underneath the nine.
Right, and try and bank the one ball up table.
Exactly.
Hopefully, get it on the side rail so that he's not left with.
Yeah,
anything.
So hopefully he can stick him under there. Johnny's a decent jumper, so I mean,
he's a solid jumper for mm-hmm. sure.
I see him hitting this shot.
Ooh.
Oh, he didn't have much of that one, and looking
unforced
at it now.
Unforced error.
Oh. Yeah, oh boy.
Now I know I'd be shooting that 1-9.
I think you
sure.
have to almost, you know. Yeah,
well,
I think
you've got
you have
the four.
To.
You got the four. It's just a funny layout of the table.
Table giving it to him. Go ahead. It's so close to the hole.
Yeah, if it doesn't come into play now, it's going to come into play later and might.
Yeah.
Might,
now you got ball in hand.
Up.
You got JB sitting in the way there. No.
JB.
Poor JB. Nice guy.
Runs a good tournament at Golden Cue on Sunday night.
He sure does. There's a good day. Okay, so.
That was unexpected.
And that's what that shooting off the rail a little
bit.
It was
very, the cue ball was placed really tightly between that one ball and the
He didn't have to elevate on that, but for some reason he decided to elevate on that, and that pushed that one ball just a little bit over.
Jumped it.
Yeah, and so
I have that tendency, but that's because I'm a little weaker player, and I feel like when I elevate, I hit a truer spot that I'm aiming to when I'm that close to the rail, because he was so close to the rail.
Yeah,
it's not true, but in my head, that's how I feel.
Makes sense. Oh no, absolutely. Hey, that's how I do too. Whether it's right or wrong, I feel like I stick true to myself. Well, Johnny's.
Well, they're just breaking down.
Yeah. Well, look at there though. Look at here. Johnny's got to calm down a little bit. He's a little excited right now. I don't think he anticipated being on this table, huh? I think there might be cause for Heineken's for Johnny King. No. All right. Okay, so Chris can't get away here. Where is he going to go, though? This is not an easy shot.
Skin it and go.
Oh, he did beat the six. Very, very nice. He's hitting some shots good.
His safeties
Chrissy's are prime. Come to play.
Wow, and look how that two ball landed. That two ball ended up really nicely behind that six ball.
So now if Johnny can get a half of this deuce.
Push the deuce out and stick the cue ball behind there.
If he can get there, but you know what? I don't see it. I think that you got to kick to a smaller portion on this deuce and let the cue ball come back here and maybe hope to get blocked by the 7, 8, or 9. Yeah. You know.
And send it down table and back up.
Oh, yeah. So let's see what he tries. Oh, no, he says he can get under there beautifully.
That's as good as you could hit it right there.
That was honest. Awesome. So, and he took away the angle to the deuce, too. He got slid up on that six. So, considering this tough kick here, I mean, you got really a really difficult kick here.
He might try and
would
tie
you consider,
something up.
Yeah, I mean, he's not even looking at it.
Well, but the problem is you don't have an easy tie-up either. What are you going to push?
Well, I mean,
you're not straight in on anything. You're not.
You can maybe try to kick the six over to the bottom rail where the five is, but he feels like he can hit this two rails out. So
the kick is just as hard as
that's too tight.
The
it just that bottom rail is not going to react properly when you're at that. You know.
The speed.
Yeah.
You gotta hit it a little softer so it allows it to open up to that.
Once he hit it hard like that, it was gone. Mm-hmm. It just tightened up right like that. So.
Or you have to play for the tightness and aim at a different.
Yeah.
Different point.
Yeah.
These are playing a little like diamonds. They're playing a little short today.
This table, for sure. I know that the other tables over there, I think they play a little more open.
A little looser. Yeah. But they're still playing a little tighter than I'm used to. These aren't. I'm not sure what tables these are.
They're called globals.
Oh, okay. I'm playing. Yeah. But I'm used to Brunswicks and diamonds, so these play kind of in between those two.
Sure. Yeah. Yeah, they're by no means are they bad tables. They're
very,
very nice.
Very nice. I was lucky I got to play Efren earlier in the tournament. Yeah, that was wonderful. I got a bye and then I played Ef. And
for the bye, right?
Right. I made a bank combo on the nine and it played real nice to the hole. So I'm not complaining.
Take that, Effie.
I won 3 games, okay? That's my claim to fame. Although I think Steve's
Listica?
Won a few more.
Oh no, yeah, it's all Steve.
Chipotle.
Oh, I tell you what, Stevie, he's been playing a lot lately, and this is not. You know, you're starting out. You're a little bit nervous. He's trying to do a little too much with that cue ball. So spinning it that little extra inside angle, he spun it right
was
through
just
the
to
hit.
Miss it.
Yeah. So,
but now Chris has to really spin this one to get
either that or hold it with a touch of inside, right?
I mean, spin it inside or spin it a lot outside.
Right. So he's got to decide what he's going to do. The outside one can get away from him.
That one.
Inside one.
I'd be worried about running into it, but he's absolutely
outside.
Spinning
he
that.
No, he's going
wait
inside.
A minute.
He's on inside. That way you can control the ball a lot easier. It doesn't get away from you.
The outside, you might run into the balls. There's a lot of problems you could come into.
I think a really good choice. Okay, he's just going to come back out. He's going to try to get straight in on the eight ball
just
in the side pocket.
And just come right out.
Yeah, one or two rails depending on what angle he's got. Oh. Okay, so
with the inside.
Those kind of hits.
And he did.
You know, when you're stretched out like that, look at the disc. I mean, he missed his hit by two Q-tips and hit inside. He was trying to hit outside there.
Come here, yeah.
That's kind of scary.
He was trying to be shooting it in the other side.
Yeah, so, I mean, he's
very
fortunate.
He's lucky to be able to see a pocket here.
Oh, absolutely.
It's not an easy pocket, but he can see a pocket.
Okay, so he likes to spin his cue ball, so he'll probably play two rails out of this corner, I'm thinking. You know, I don't know. I mean, he does like to turn
come
his cue
into
ball.
The, his
he's a,
left?
He's a fun, no, he's going inside English.
Yeah, that's what I meant.
Okay.
Oh, no, he only went one. I thought he would spin out two rails as well.
Yeah, he's going to take this in the corner. I think he was playing to get it in the side, but...
Came a little short on it.
Yeah. Well, you know, they're both trying to... You know, I think the pressure's more
sometimes
on Johnny than Chris, because Chris is just coming up, and
Chris
Johnny, he's been established for a while.
At various tournaments, I remember in Sacramento, he had a nice
shot, yeah.
And, but yeah, I agree, like, it's kind
shot
of
making machine, this little kid, you know?
Well, on the eight ball, I think perhaps he was just trying to make the ball. He was a little off angle, and he's like, I can shoot it in the side, I can shoot it in the corner, let me just make sure I hit a good ball on this.
Yeah, I was kind of shocked on how that cue ball came. Uh-oh. It's the road people on the, you know, Johnny's road dog is trying to get him into the Heine Kang.
This is a great view from here. We got Johnny and Chris. You got Bustamante on the next table and Edward on the table down. This
I
is
tell
awesome.
You what, I mean, you can't get better than this. Look at this. See, now, when you're not comfortable, these kind of little things, I tell you. Look
you
at the.
You can see he's struggling.
But you look at this, though. Now, the deuce came into play.
It makes a whole difference.
Yeah.
He's got nothing going on here.
Yeah, he's got to play a safe right out of the gate.
And the safe isn't easy.
Unless he wants to play the 1-8 combo, but I mean, it's an option.
You certainly can shoot it, but... It's not an easy combo, and you don't advance from it. You might lose the one ball.
Oh, I don't like this at all. I might get a little aggressive and shoot this combo, only saying the reason why is the safety. Well, no, the safety. You can play a safe here.
Well,
just bump it.
I would shoot the bank on the one and try and pull down and just leave him to the end rail with the one ball.
I think he's going to play the 1-8, I think.
It's tough to get the cue ball in a good spot to shoot.
Well, the one's going to squirt towards the corner pocket.
To the other
and
corner.
You just hold your cue ball right there. I don't know. This is...
I have no idea what's happening.
I mean, you should slice this one and go behind the 6-4, but I don't want to shoot it. Oh, he's just going to shoot the one, bank
is
the
he
one back
it
here.
Pull and it into the 8.
Yeah, that's what he's going to do. So,
it's not good.
That's the problem with those kind of shots, you know. No, it's no good.
It's not short by much.
No, he missed it. Missed it pretty bad, but
it comes.
When you miss that kind of shot, look.
Yeah, he's got the ball.
What he's going to try to do is he's going to try and
cut it.
Beat the 5.
Uh-huh.
But he's got nothing else. He's got no shot on that 2-9 combo. So what's he going to do? He's got to play. He might want to play safe here.
Bank the...
He needs this game badly.
So you bank the one to the end rail and try and run the cue ball up tape? Is that possible?
Well, look at it. He wants to make the ball. He wants to go
he
after
to
it
shoot.
So
he
bad.
He's a shooter.
Yeah, and so... But what he does this, and he makes the balls, but he just doesn't know where the cue ball's going. He got... You know what?
He ends up not
He was
too
playing
shabby.
To the outside. He came out really nice. But still, this is a difficult shot.
I like shooting these combos like this. He's shooting that 2 into the rail to come out and catch the 9, which means unless you get completely unlucky, the 9 will come out of play if you don't make it. You're not leaving them the 2-9.
Yeah, it's kind of a natural shot on the bottom of the cue ball. You just can kind of line it up pretty good.
Yeah.
But it's tough. You got to get
it
off the rail.
Shot, but he didn't hang the nine. You know, Chris still has some work to do.
All right.
It's not too tough a table, but
yeah,
it's a little work. I think the first shot is going to be the deciding factor if he gets good on this three ball.
Yeah, I think, you know, if he needs an angle on this three to get back to the four. So he's going to play this to, like, the, you know, like in the middle inside. Of the. Yeah, he's going to just try to beat the side. Oh, he dug in big time.
And he didn't dig in enough.
Yeah. Well, when I shoot that shot, I play for just beating the side, or like you said, just really draw it and draw it way out.
I tend to go ahead and just draw it.
Draw it out.
Yeah, because my angles are not as solid as yours, so I get afraid of that side pocket. And I want to take it completely.
It's totally understandable. So now he's just going to kick two rails and try to get out of there. He's going to try
send
to
the
create
three
some stuff.
Yeah. Hold the cue ball down table.
So the three's going to hopefully slice towards the corner, and the cue ball is going to run towards that piece of chalk down there at the end of the table over there. Oh, the one he just picked up. Now, either way, he can get under the three and do it, or he can kick on the top of it. So if he hits it full in the face, that's the only time it's bad, and he turned the heck out of that ball, yeah. They're both getting a little, and then Chris is getting a little nervous of his position in this match.
He got ahead, and it's kind of sharpening him a little bit.
Yeah, he's a little bit nervous with his position, because Johnny's been a well-established player for a while now.
Well, and he's done very well in these Mezz events to date. He didn't have a great Fresno, but prior to that, hard times, he took third behind Geronimo and Mystica, yeah. So I mean.
I tell you what, he can play any of those guys.
For sure.
Yeah, he's playing nice right now.
And he's confident playing anybody. Especially, yeah. You know, it's a single race. He knows he can beat anybody even. And he goes to eight, is that correct?
Yeah, he's going to eight, so he got a little bit of an advantage.
Against the top guys, that's a lot for him.
Mm-hmm. But, you know, when you're dealing with the top players, yeah, you just, look at this.
Ooh. That's
so.
You go forward a little bit, or you try and draw it back a little
bit? Yeah, I know Johnny so well. I'm feeling he's going to crank through this. Unless he's really nervous, he'll just draw it back and take the slice on the eight.
You're right.
He's nervous. Yeah, you don't ever do that.
But he can see the ball, and he's got a shot.
Yeah.
And so he's always dangerous.
He's trying to get out of this feeling he's feeling right now. He's got to get out here. He's thinking to himself, I must get out. But what you're looking at is, you know, a pretty severe cut.
Yeah, he's got to just bear down and make the ball and take what he gets on the nine ball.
Yeah.
Can't worry about anything.
With severe cuts come over slices, which is very common, you know.
Yeah, you get behind the ball because you're just.
But Chris, he didn't leave Chris like a hanger here.
He's got a tough shot to come back to.
It's going to be interesting to see what Chris does here.
He's in the zone. I can't really make eye contact at this point.
I don't think he wants to talk to nobody nor see anybody. He's he's disgusted with his position right now, but he's still got action. And Chris is going for the wrong shot here.
You got to cut the other corner.
But he gets he does these kind of things every once in a while. He gets a little uncomfortable. Yeah, he should be cutting towards the corner away from him.
Yeah, it's
not
a natural shot. This is you've got to spin it too much. You lose the cue ball. He must like it. He didn't even seem to look at the other shot.
He probably practices this shot, but by the way, that is not the right shot.
He would have had a look, but if you cut it this way, if you overhit it, it's going to come back to the end rail. I mean, Johnny has a tough shot to go with right here, but the other way is a much safer and much more comfortable shot. Like,
yeah.
The other shot is just you're having to do a lot of twisting.
Yeah, that's, I mean, but like, you know, one shot for you might be different for the other
person. For sure, and he walked up to it looking very confident.
He liked that slice. He liked that shot.
It's kind of like this shot. You can shoot it either way, too, you know. I've seen people shoot it to the other corner. And
Johnny is just way out of his game right now.
I want to yell at him now.
Yeah. Well, again, he left Chris with a very difficult shot. This shot here, I mean, you got to be dead center. Oh, I just found out who my next opponent is, little Marianne, and she just gave me the two fingers to the eyes, calling me out.
She is watching him.
Oh, my God, I'm in trouble. All right, so dead center. If he tries to elevate or do anything here, he's taking his chances away from pocketing the ball. So I
started cutting this ball as well, and I know that's what you're rooting for here. But for many years, I just banked it. I did.
I mean, it's not.
I can hit it full. I don't have to worry about it.
He's going. He goes maybe a touch outside. He looks like, but that'll get him to overslice that ball. No.
You know, both of them are kind of. Like a jump in there when they're going to hit it. They're over.
And now
body movement is happening.
And now the table's kind of getting their little. It's little call and saying, hey, you know what? I'm going to show you guys that. Who I'm favoring, Chris, I guess. So he can't see an edge of that or nothing? I mean, he's looking like he's going to jump this.
I thought he went and got the jump cube.
Wow, well, I tell you what, this is, to me, this is a hard jump shot. Something's bound to fly off the table from here, you know? So it looks to me like he can find the edge of that eight. Am I wrong?
No. I think he can certainly masse to it. He looks like he's shooting at it.
He can see the edge.
You're doing the one pocket crossover bank?
Hmm?
If he can see the edge, there's the one rail crossover bank that you do in one pocket back to your hole.
Yeah, that's his shot. If he can see,
if he can see any of it.
Yeah, I think he can, but the
by the way, further on our row is also Geronimo and Ernesto. All this row is just an awesome row of pool player right now.
Yeah, we're not too short of champions in this tournament.
No, not at all. It's got a little massive happening.
So Johnny opt for the jump, and you know what?
That's not good.
Not good. And so Chris, being the young guy, you know, he's showing emotion a little more than most people do, and Johnny's trying to be all stellar and. It's kind of fun watching new generations coming in, and Chris has got to, you know, I mean, he's
a little short on that too.
Yeah,
gotta just make it in the hole.
Yeah, he's gotta.
Gonna back cut it in the side. Pull it to
the side. He's fully extended out.
Oh my goodness.
Oh boy, you see this.
But again, the table's like, hey, I'm still rooting for Chris. Yeah. I mean, he could have easily just hung that ball up in the corner. Instead, Johnny's got a tough cut on this ball.
Yeah. Yeah.
He should make it, but it's a tough cut.
When I'm thinking for Johnny here, I'm thinking, you know, like, he hasn't found the edge of the ball yet. You know what I mean?
He's
shot
found
like four
it.
Shots.
He's found into it.
Shot oversliced it. He's hit it thick. He's just really uncomfortable with the edge right now, so we'll see what happens here.
He's aiming really low on this ball.
Oh, Johnny. Beautiful shot, Johnny.
I was surprised at how low he hit that ball.
Heine King. Oh, yeah. He's a pretty happy man now. Gets to live true to his word now. Heine Kang. So now Chris has just lost a little of his momentum. He's had every opportunity to win that game.
Everyone seems to be struggling a little bit over there. This match has gone on for a long time.
Well, Chris has been playing very well. He's playing in every event. And as you keep playing in all these events, you start getting comfortable, a lot more comfortable.
the TV table is always a little nerve-wracking.
It is. It is. Yeah.
One of the girls was joking about when I played Efren about putting us on the TV table. I said, I don't care. Like, I've rode the nine a million times on the TV table.
I've looked bad millions of times. It doesn't matter to me. So he's going to kick this ball. He's going to try to make it, I think. I don't know, though. I mean,
you can do that. Yeah, the rail first and come out. It's a little far from the pocket. But
the three goes in the side. So even if he makes it, yeah, the cue ball is going right towards the position.
Can he catch the six? Is there a way that he might hit that funny and catch the six?
Yeah, I honestly, I'm not liking the shot, but I'm thinking that's probably he might jump it. He might do, I don't know what he's going to do.
That was a weird aiming technique. I'm not sure what he's going to do.
He wants to get out. So what he's trying to say is, I want to get on the other side of that one so I can slice it in.
So,
it was a really nice shot. Really nice shot.
I think he's going to get, no?
The only way he would have done,
yeah,
exactly. The only way he would have done bad there is if he would have hit the front side of the one.
The other side of it.
Yeah. Then he would have caught the six.
Oh, Efren got the game, it looks like.
So, I don't know. Steve might have just won.
I thought Efren got that, but it's possible. I don't know.
What happened there?
Everybody clapped, and I don't know.
They didn't clap real loud.
I know, so I don't have any idea.
All right, so
Johnny tried. We'll find out in a minute.
Yeah, Johnny tried to play kind of soft there. And
It looks like there's a carom to the nine ball.
Yeah.
But
he'll go that route. He's going to go with a nine, but it's
Well, you can, as you carom, there's a you can cut the one or you can bank the one to play safe, depending on how much you have to hit it.
A little bit of a two-way shot.
Yeah.
Speed is a big issue here, though. Do you hit it with draw or you hit it with follow? If he hits it with draw, he has more control, and the cue ball stays down there. Or if he hits it with follow, he might just slice the nine, and the cue ball will come with the one. So I think he's drawing this.
He's hitting it center. Looks like center, kind of a punch stroke.
Yeah. So he tried the draw. He got distance.
Well, Steve didn't come up to chime in, so I'm thinking that maybe Efren won and he's out there hitting balls until they kick
him off. Is that what Efren does when he wins?
Not always, but I think he's struggling a little bit, and I think he's trying to just get comfortable. Whether he won or lost, he's trying to get comfortable with what's going on.
Good point. Yeah, Steve didn't come back up. You see, this.
If Steve had won, I believe he would have come right up.
He would have been cheering, smiling, grinning. Yeah. So the cue ball under the nine, one ball up here towards the seven, right?
And now Tang's going to be taking over on that table. I'm not sure who he's going to be playing, but that's another great match.
Yeah.
Tang's been doing very well in these events as well.
Yes, Tang. He's trying to show some heart.
Yeah. He took fifth, sixth at Fresno.
Yeah, and had a great opportunity from what he told me. He said he had
he struggled against Geronimo.
Oh, did he?
He had a good opportunity against Vilmos on the winner's side.
Yeah, that's what I think he was a little bummed about.
He kind of sidestepped him. Then against Geronimo, he didn't really come with his mojo.
Yeah. And that's hard. That's easy to do, you know. That there was a nice shot. Very, very good speed. So,
and it looks like Geronimo won his match, so that puts him through on the winner's side till tomorrow.
Yeah. Yeah, he's definitely one of the favorites in the tournament.
What's not to like? Makes balls.
Yeah.
Well, you played him first round.
Yeah, I did. Son of a...
Had a couple missed opportunities.
No, just kidding. You know what? I did. I had some opportunities, but, it's hard out there. First match.
When we talked about this table makes it that much tougher.
Yeah. I actually played well out of the gate. That happens. So here we are. You know, he might want to make this ball, but to me, I overslice this ball. Oh, he's gonna hit it thick and try to put the cue ball on the six.
Wow, you're gonna try and two rail it out of that corner and lay the cue ball up on the six ball?
If he has enough one ball, he does want to do that.
Just
absolutely.
Says it,
You're playing the one ball here towards the eight, right? The one towards the eight.
Yeah.
No, he went for the shot.
Wow. I liked your shot.
Yeah. Or maybe he didn't have enough one ball.
I felt like I learned. Well, he half jumped the four ball as it was, so I felt like with the jump that he would have had enough to do what you were talking about.
Yeah.
And I felt like I learned a new shot that I can incorporate. I like that. The two rails down, and
yeah,
that's nice.
Yeah, and then try to hold that cue ball down.
And if not for nine ball, for one pocket, for sure.
Oh, yeah. Oh, a lot of shots can go towards one pocket. Oh, and Johnny just missed that ball, too. He's struggling.
I'm coming for you, Dave.
That would be Miss Mary Ann. She's coming for Dave in the next round.
That's not fair, Mary. Take it easy, Mary.
I fought hard. You better not let me see that ball.
Oh, listen, I already know. I'm not even... Are you kidding me? I played you at hard times. You were making everything.
She's a ginger snap.
Match, man. I'm on a roll.
So exciting. I think these are first matches won.
I think so.
This is my first. I won a match today. Marianne won a match today. It's a good day.
All the girls are having a good old time now. See?
Meanwhile, Melissa's in too deep on the winner's side.
And
Jenny and Lee and Stacy as well.
Huh?
I think Jenny Lee and Stacy as well.
Oh, man. All right.
There's a lot of
girls' tournament going on here. Well, it looks like he's opening up a can of worms here against Johnny.
You get lucky? You get lucky? Did you win? Efren won his match.
He's always a lucky man, Efren. It's very heavy.
I won a match.
Yeah, you still playing today?
Bustamani's still playing. We can't leave yet. Efren wants me to take him home.
Oh, he wants to go home.
He's tired.
He wants to go have a Budweiser.
When you're on the road with a pool player like me, you just got to take your lumps. You got to hang out.
Well, you know, these guys work hard. If people don't realize what they do, is Efren and Boosty have been taking pictures ever since
they
come
really
into
have.
The building.
Well, and aside from that, they flew in from the Philippines last night.
Yeah.
We went and had dinner over at Epic Billiards.
Uh-huh.
And we're there for quite a few hours. And then they went home and slept for a few hours.
That's the lifestyle. Oh, okay.
Till I lose. So maybe one. He's ready to go.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, so he's done for the
day? Yeah, that puts him through to the winner's side. On the
Oh, game. Good for him.
Well,
my day's just getting started.
He beat somebody, and then he had me second. I was his second round match.
Oh.
So anytime you draw Brooke second round of a tournament,
you're doing pretty good. Yeah,
you're
doing pretty good.
And if you're seeing flashes, that's...
Such a generous man. As usual, Efren gives away his food.
We made a side wager that if I won two games in our match, that he had to buy me lunch.
Ah.
I don't think leftovers...
Does that constitute a lunch? I think you might have a piece of chicken in there.
I think he needs
maybe
to buy
a drumstick
me some real food.
Or something.
This you didn't even pay for this.
Couldn't just heat it up or anything, could you?
Did you pay for this? That does not count as our bet. I'm gonna take it because I'm hungry. But
so back to the match. Johnny and Chris. Johnny's two, and Chris is three.
He's playing.
Johnny just made a very nice out there, so. He's ducking the camera. Efren, we want you to do some commentating.
I tried to grab him. He's quick.
He is. He's quick.
What? I didn't do anything with it. I don't know what he's... He was playing chess with one of the guys earlier.
Ah, yeah,
lost
of course.
His chess set.
Uh-oh. So let's see. Chris has a gathered together here a little bit more. And
that was a nice gathering.
Yeah, not bad there.
He's going to be able to masse around the nine ball, but it's, you know, he's going to be back in control of the table.
Yeah, he hit that really nice.
He hit the good side of that ball. I didn't realize he could hit that much of the ball.
Very, very nice.
I now have Efren Reyes's cue and chess board if anybody wants to make offers.
And nobody ever says that Efren's not a gamesman.
Everything's
for
sale.
He's got games. So he's got about an eighth of his ball. I don't know what the heck he's going to do.
Is he going to try and pull it to the side rail and bank the one out?
No, it looks like he's going forward and trying to run
it.
He made it. Wow.
And he cleared the three ball at least. It looks like the four ball's still in a bad spot, but.
Yeah, this is not a nice out. This is not a nice table right now. I don't even like this safe. This safe just does not look easy at all here.
Maybe come off the right side of the one underneath the six.
He's going to try to cut the two by the seven.
Oh.
Yeah. But it's just not a. That was.
The only thing this does is leave it really tough to get back on a three.
Yeah, you're just leaving distance. I mean, that's all you could do there. Say something to all your fans. Come on, Effie. Tell them how you really feel. I'm tired. I want to go home.
Ano ba yung Filipino or Chinese?
There you go.
But speaks Filipino.
Oh, Chinese. Can you play?
So, he's going to pop the shot three rails, right? I mean, what is he going
to
do here?
There's nothing else to do. The only problem is he's got a lot of balls he can
win. He's ripping. He's drawing it back.
Oh.
Oh, he's drawing right in there.
Look at that. He played a save.
Too hard again.
And he did hit it too hard. He's got a full ball.
Yeah, but still.
Four balls tough.
Still a hard shot. I mean, to shoot the shot slow is
Sorry.
Oh, Boosty, you got to keep playing.
I got to stay in play. That's all right. I'll meet them up. It's okay.
They're tired.
They can't get too far. I have the house keys.
There you go. Yeah, he just made the ball. He was trying to hit the nine with the cue ball, and he missed it.
Efren's coaching.
So. So Efren looks like he doesn't need a mic. He'll just start yelling across the room.
That's how it rolls. Try going cross-state with that. It's wonderful. It's a lot of fun, actually.
Oh, he hit that chunky. But he's going
to
get away with it, I think.
It. He hit it
really nice, actually.
Depends on what he was actually trying to do.
I think that's what he was probably trying to do, yeah. I just saw it.
He thought he was doing something else.
Yeah. Very, very nice. I would have won, came in wide and probably sold out, and he hit it better. So this is the tough hit here. I mean, you got to go two rails or three rails. That's really what the ideal is.
You got to go three. One, yeah. Two, side, bottom, side, and come into it. There's not much else you can do.
Then you're kicking the three towards the six, hopefully. So he's spinning this. He's putting some English on it, and
he hit it good.
He hit it pretty good.
Let's see what he ends up with. He hit it good. He might be able to catch the outside of it, but that was a very nice recovery.
Yeah. Oh, absolutely. Oh, shit.
Good friends. That's what's
very
happening.
Handsome man.
Oh, shoot. This job gets tough. So, spinning two rails, he's going to try to hit the rail before he hits the three, or he's just going right into the three? Yeah, he tried to do that. That gets a little fancy, and that gets you in trouble. What do you just think?
He just wandered around. I'm still in.
No, I'm still in the tournament. Huh? I'm still in the tournament.
There's no cussing on the
You're still in the tournament? What the shot?
These are my friends. This is true.
It's unbelievable. You're still in tournament. Supposed to be personal check.
On table two. I gotta go play on table two.
All right.
Oh, Brookie. That's good. Brookie gets on table two. Oh, Johnny's struggling still. Good luck there, Brookie. Brookie.
I don't know.
Does he see an edge or what? What do you think? You see, he's such a giver and a taker. He took the chicken back. Brooke missed out on her meal. All right.
Boy, Dave, you're just having way too much fun over there.
I am. I'm guilty.
It's good to have you, man. I'm really glad to see you playing.
Oh, thanks, man.
In the game, you know.
Trying.
Yeah. Well, you know, that's all you can do is try.
You know what? Whether I do good or not, I just want this to be here for a long time.
Yeah, I'd like it to be here next year.
You
next,
know.
Have a, you know,
I mean,
more seasons, more growth, more venues.
Exactly.
You know, more spectators, more players for pool. It's just great, you know.
Oh, absolutely.
It really is.
I don't know if either of these players have gotten comfortable yet, you know.
For someone like you too, Dave, you know, you teach, you have a lot of students, you know.
What's that?
For someone like you, you teach, you have a lot of students.
Yeah.
You know, this gives you, this type of tour gives you
a goal
for your students to say, hey, you know, this is the next step for you, you know, come to the Mezz West State Tour, play this.
Oh, yeah.
You know, I mean, that's just great.
Yeah, I mean, I welcome any of that stuff, but I just love the game. And
yeah,
anytime I can find somebody who wants to love it as much as me, that's a bonus. All right, guys, I got to go play.
Dave,
I got my little Marianne. Thank
who
you.
Who are you playing?
Marianne. And she looked at me and stared me down, so I'm
oh,
nervous.
She mad dogged you, huh? All right. All right, well, I guess I'm coming back with you guys. I'll be stepping over the caution tape, and I'll be back with you in a second.
HustlerFotch at yahoo.com.
Hi.
Important matches going on here. I know. I get the feeling these guys are a little tired. You know, I just don't see that. It seems like Chris is playing a little better right now, but I've seen him play better than this, and Johnny Kang, I don't think, has really shown up to the match the way he could be. I don't know what is going on with him internally right now, but he could just be tired. We are, by the way,
I'm going to bring you my tour in the cash.
Okay. Later on? Okay. I'll tell Brooke. Yeah. Are you going home?
No, I'm going to take for you on table four.
Okay. Efren just told me to tell Brooke that he'll be back. So, 91 players today at the Mezz West State Tour stop number 4, and we are going to get it down to 24 players by the end of the night. So we'll break it down to 24 players. Tomorrow, you will be following with us the final 24. And a lot of people have been eliminated. I'm not going to do another video bracket for Facebook until later on this evening. I'm really sorry, but we had a lot of players today, and it just seems like it's a lot of work to update a bracket that is only going to be viewed for about an hour. But many heads have rolled in this 91-player bracket so far. Art Garcia, Chris Fangre's friend, he's out. Who else is out? I can't remember. I don't know. Mike Meeker's out? Aw. Well, my man Mike Meeker, he's out. And I see John Schmidt is in a game right now with Branch Talley. Stacy Novak's playing Dave Martineau. Bacon is playing Hiroko. Branch Talley's playing either John Schmidt or Jim Burt. Looks like Ramon Mystica is in a match with Ramin. No, that's not Ramin. Tony Ortega is in a match with Tang Ho. Brooke Thomason is about to start her match right now. She's playing with Brian Katie. Vilmos Foldes is playing Arturo Rivera. Ooh.
Accent, your hungry accent.
My hungry accent. Actually, who is Ramon Mystica playing? I can't see his face. Santos Samahon is still in. I see that. Score in this match right now is 4-2. Here's an opportunity for Chris to settle in and string a few pearls. Let's see if he can do this. It's getting a little painful to see these guys make so many errors in a row with each other, but I can understand how sometimes matches just play out like that. Sometimes even top players struggle. Vas a agarrar para ti. Chris did not. Well, he might be all right. But he really didn't want to have any angle on this five. I wouldn't have played for any angle. I would have played to either get straight in front of it or straight behind it. But this works out for him. I just think that shot carried a little too much risk with the eight ball there. A nine ball is going to hurt him if he's not careful. No. He played the shot right. He played it slow. And managed to get a perfect angle for the seven in the corner. Draw back for the eight. Santos Sambajon's playing Melissa Herndon. It's Nick Spano is playing Jeffrey Long. And that does look like Ramin Bakhtari playing Ramon Mystica. He totally dogged it. Johnny Kang coming back now. Johnny Kang. And that was just wonderful. Poor Johnny, man. He's struggling today. And I'm not really sure if it's today, as it might just be this match. I'm not really sure. Sorry, this is a, you know what? We're done with winner's side, so you know what? Maybe I will get you some names. Chris Fangre won that game. Break by Johnny. He's got a chance now to do something. Please do something, my friend. Come at this shot. A little inside follow. Not too much. He's perfect. He'll be all right here. Yes. All right, Mr. Meeker. Yeah.
He went to the bar.
Johnny Kang takes another game.
What's the score?
What's the score? Score is 5-3. Johnny Kang trailing by 2. lot of scrappy play here in this match between these two guys.
Efren said he'll be back. Oh. Efren said he'll be back. He took it with him.
He took it because he told me he was.
No, he.
Yeah, sure.
Took it with him, yeah. Tell Brooke, are you thinking.
Gerald Hansel.
We're playing jokesies on Brooke Thomason right
now. That wasn't funny. It was a little.
Another nice break. This time by Chris. Yeah, let's see if Chris can answer the call by Johnny, who pulled a break and run. Tell you what, this could be one of those Tom Cruise runouts.
It's like a nightmare.
Well, this is the only shot. See, the thing is with this shot, he's got to get kind of perfect on the four. He can't get off angle. He doesn't want to get out of line. Whoa, he went for the side.
Wow, it's a nice shot.
Well, that's perfect. That is perfect.
Is this still on the winner's side?
No, this is a one-loss side, so the loser of this match is going to be eliminated. You know, it's amazing to see, you know, Chris is a very good player, but it's amazing to see how they would play, you know, other players would play a pattern where I would totally play it different, you know what I mean?
Yeah. I mean, I see outs differently sometimes than what, you know, people do. Especially watching Oscar's game earlier, I was like, still have a lot to learn.
Yeah, I guess, you know, I mean, myself included, I feel like you're always learning when you play this game, you know. You're always learning. As long as you're, you know, open to it, you're always learning. Chris looks to be
got a little off on that.
Yeah, he had a little bit of a surge of adrenaline maybe on that shot, but he's gonna have to really pull off a good shot. You know, a pretty good shot. Let's just say he's gonna have to stun it across one rail and back over.
That was perfect.
That was perfect. And also a sign that Johnny and that Chris is starting to feel his, you know, gain some stride here and feel a little more comfortable. That'll be 6-3. And I think this puts Chris on the hill against Johnny, who's got to go to 8. So Chris could be very well be on the hill here. I'm not sure if he's in as a 7 or an 8.
Broke dry, left him a shot. no real problem balls on the table. Maybe the 5 to the 6.
Yeah, welcome to the World Cup of Pool after dark.
Right.
That's right. World Cup of Pool is over around 3 o'clock. Come on down to the Mezz West Day Tour after dark.
Bring a friend.
Bring a friend, yeah. Bring 2 friends.
So I went to Rite Aid next door, and a couple kids were in line in front of me.
Sorry, go ahead.
A couple kids were in line in front of me, and they said, "So, there's a little pool competition going on next door." I go, "Yeah, little, about 100 players, players from all around the world, but yeah, little."
It's funny, isn't it? How you can get this like world-class field just coming to play any tournament they can,
right?
When they get here, you know?
Exactly.
I need to play. I need action.
You know,
it's like, wow.
It was funny, my last match, a guy played, dogged a shot, and I go, "You don't have to do that. I'm not going to gamble with you after this."
Chris caught himself out of line here. I don't like
you
this.
You think when people are on the hill like this, it's overconfidence?
Oh, my God.
Or?
Look what he's doing right now. Excuse my language here, but.
Yeah.
Yeah. Uh-oh.
He was playing the safe.
Yeah. He's playing the two. Go for the two-way.
He's going to.
Anyway, I'm sorry. What were you saying, sir?
About what?
Oh, I don't know. Do you think when people get confident like this?
That's right. I said when people are on the hill like this with a good lead, do you think they get overly confident? Or do you think they get a little bit more nervous thinking I'm going to win this thing? Or?
I think it varies from person to person. I think experience is a big teacher when it comes to that type of that scenario. I think that, you know, you can be on the hill against the guy with, and he only has 2 games, and, you know, then all of a sudden he has 4 games.
I've lost a lot of matches like that.
You have 7 games, you're on the hill, you know, and then all of a sudden he has 5 games. Well, hello, pressure's on you now, man.
That's what I'm talking about.
I don't think it's, it's not, you know, I think it goes in phases.
I think if I'm up 7-2 and I'm on the hill or whatever, and sometimes I get a little bit too relaxed.
Yeah, but, you know, also there's people that could be cocky, and they're still going to win because eventually your opponent might make the mistake that he didn't want to make.
Right.
You know, I mean, and that's why people are cocky sometimes, because they know they're going to get an opportunity to come to the table. But sometimes it doesn't happen. You're right. Last night was a great night for me. I was down, and I'm not talking about money-wise or gambling, but I had a couple of really good matches. I played Chris Wedekin.
Oh, okay.
And he had me 6-2, and I came back, I beat him 8-7.
No way.
You know? Yeah.
Wow.
And then we're just practicing, you know, $20 sweat bets or whatever, or just bet.
Where was this? Is it Hard Times?
This was here.
Oh,
I was
here
setting up,
night?
And I took a little break. And then I played Romy, who asked me for weight, you know, so I gave him 2 on the wire into a race to 8. And, you know, I got him 8-4 in the first one, but in the second one he had me 6-2, and then I came back and beat him 8-6, you know. So, I know never to be cocky, but you know what, even I get cocky, you know, I mean, it just happens.
Right.
Anyway, that's the long answer to your question. And who just won this rack?
Johnny.
Oh, good for Johnny. It's Chris. It's Mike Meeker, man. Good guy.
I like it. Looks dramatico. Looks dramatico.
Thanks, Mauricio. Mauricio's here, and he's taking pictures. It's always great to see him around with his camera. He travels back and forth to El Salvador. Takes care of his family. So, how about you? Do you get like, if you feel like you're gonna win, you get cocky, like, I'm gonna win this.
I get relaxed. I don't like to call it cocky. I get relaxed. Good, man.
Oh.
What? I want to introduce Justin Logan, who beat Foldis to the loser side.
That's right, Justin Logan. Hey, man, how's it going?
I got lucky. Real lucky.
Yep. You beat him, seven games to six?
7-6, yeah. And then I got beat up by John Schmidt, so it happens.
I was talking to Vilmos, because he won the last tour stop. I was talking to him. He said, yes, I did not show up on time to the match.
he said, I didn't show up on time to the match?
No, he said, I did not show up on time to the match.
I guess.
Basically meaning he was there, but he wasn't there.
He didn't miss much, dude. I got to give credit to that guy, dude. He doesn't miss much at all. He just got some bad rolls.
Well, it must have been a good high for you to beat him.
Yeah, and unfortunately, I just didn't capitalize in my next match. I wish I could have.
Yeah, I understand. Hey. Well, why don't I let Mike and Justin hang out for a little while?
Let's hang out.
All right. You got to sweat your boy Johnny Kang, right?
Yeah, dude.
All right. Justin Logan, one of our old-time favorites here on POV Pool.
Hometown heroes.
Woo. That's right. He is a hometown hero. If you ever have a raffle, don't let him buy tickets.
Never let me buy tickets.
Well, like Daniel says, Justin always draws the monsters and always wins the raffles.
Yeah. You know, when you draw Shane Van Boning first round in the 10 ball and, like, you know... I went to Derby City and I drew Stuart Pettman first round right after he won like the street pool competition or like had the high run on a 10-foot table or something like that. Ridiculous. Let's see what Johnny's doing.
Johnny, I think, is down 6-4.
Yeah, and what is Chris go to?
I think seven. I think Chris is on the hill.
Chris only needs seven?
One.
Johnny Kang, always a tournament favorite. Plays super good.
Yeah, Johnny's one of my personal favorites, too. Efren had his stuff laying here.
Really?
And I guess Efren said, I'm going to take my stuff, so tell Brooke I took my stuff. So Brooke comes running over, and she's like, where's Efren's stuff? Daniel's girlfriend has this.
And it's just gone.
That was mean. It's 6-4. Chris.
And
6-5 now, yeah.
Looks like Johnny's going to get out of this wreck pretty comfortably. Is he on the break next?
No, I think he broke. Yeah, actually, he might be on the break next, yeah.
Looks like it's Johnny's break. Hopefully with a run out, he could tie this up 6-6.
How do we I don't know. I don't know how to do that.
I know that we're not updating the score right now, but Johnny Kang is breaking and down 6-5.
I don't either. It's the only thing I know how to push is where this one right here, where you could go to the different tables. Let's see. That's all I know.
Johnny Kang, one of the bigger breakers out of Hard Times Bellflower. Always a... And looks like it's going to be a dry break.
Yeah, but not an easy leave.
Yeah, he didn't end up bad or anything. You're not sweating this like I'm not going to come back to the table, but it all depends on what Chris can do with it. Chris, also a Hard Times Bellflower player, super solid.
A lot of hard time Ian's in here.
Well, when you get a tournament going over in Northridge, a lot of the LA people are going to be able to make it because it's only about maybe 45 minutes away from LA.
Right. Well, that's what brought me here. It's close enough.
Yeah, close enough.
Like, and I don't think I'll do Arizona.
Yeah. You know. Well, we got 97 people in the tournament, so like that's a solid board, man. Like, it'd be nice to have the support to do a full 128 person board, but you know, 97 players ain't nothing to scoff at.
Oh, it keeps,
that's going to be rough.
Every stop, yeah. That.
It has been growing every stop, and I try to keep people as informed as possible about what's going on. But man, it would be nice to have a 6-month yearly tour going on in California.
Cool?
Yeah, every year, man. Just have like a 6-month tour where the best players in the area just come out and hit some balls around. That'd be awesome. You know, John Schmidt, a local player to Victorville, Southern California, you know.
That's right.
A lot of pros are out in the area. Johnny's looking at a little nip shot right here, but he's kind of wondering what kind of shape he's going to get on the three ball. And he's going
to...
Oh, no, no, no. He's not going to go for the side. He's going to try to nip it, draw it back a little bit, but I don't know if that shape is going to be what he wants to be able to get on the four. See, he nipped it.
Oh, he's all right.
Well, he's got to come two rails and then probably out, like, towards the four and the side.
Yeah, so the four and the side.
Yeah, hit it really thin with a little bit of top, punch it, come two rails, just like that. And he's going to have to be happy with that. He's not happy with it, but...
Yeah, I think he wanted to bring it over just a little bit more.
Johnny's the kind of player where if he feels comfortable, he's going to let out his stroke and he's going to make this ball and get shape. But it all depends what he thinks he can do with this to get shape on the five, because it looks like the five only goes in that one pocket. Coming from this side of the table, and he nipped the nine and he didn't get good.
Can yeah, he's not. Huh?
Can he hear?
No, I don't think. No, he shouldn't be able to.
No, was. Can he hear?
He can't hear you. It's called the commentator's curse.
I
feel like I made that happen with my mind.
It's like a Jedi right there. See if we can make him make the shot with my mind.
Jeez. He's gonna need some Jedi power to be able to get out of this, because he doesn't look like he has anything to work with. And
I've seen him jump out of things like this before.
Yeah, but like
that's just a tough leave all the way around.
That just doesn't look good any way you go about it. Even if you jump it and you make a hit, what are you really doing with it?
Especially when your opponent's on the hill. I mean, this is kind of a do-or-die moment.
Does Chris
for him.
Only go for? He only goes to seven.
As far as I know. Oh, look at that.
Solid contact, but it doesn't look like it's going to do him any favors.
No.
Looks like he can just punch it with top, come one rail, back out for the six ball in the same pocket. And he's going to get a little bit close to the rail on that one.
Shoot the seven in the opposite pocket.
He looks pretty straight in, so he might
just
roll forward a little bit for the seven in the opposite corner. Depends how loose he is. And he wants to check it again.
There's a lot of pressure on him. Not a lot, but I mean, he's on the hill right now, and he trying to close it out.
Man, he hit that ball good. Chris is a bit of a chin scraper, and he's really good at those shots where all you got to do is just hit it straight and roll it in. Perfect with speed right here.
Shoot the nine up top.
Yeah, he's going to go for the nine in the same pocket. And depending on how he's going to come through, either he's going to come behind the nine and then spin out, or he's going to draw back a little bit.
See, I would just roll it forward and shoot the nine up. But
well, he's got a little bit of an angle here, so he's going to he's going to drop back. Play a nine in the same pocket, straight in. Should be all right.
I don't know the guy, but I like him. Okay, so I guess Chris does go to eight.
Yeah, Chris is a good player, man, and I thought he would be even with Johnny. So now Chris is breaking and on the hill. Both racing to eight. And these turtle racks, man, they've really been holding the balls real tight. So, you know, a lot of the guys don't even need to break it all that hard. Just a medium firm hit, and then they're getting three balls past the side pocket, making the wing ball every time. So lines up with a big old stroke, and looks like it came out dry. But once again, not bad. I mean, if you're not going to make a ball on the break, that's the way to do it. And he's going to push. Going to dare him to take the one.
Yeah, he does have sight on it.
See, now, if he can play this one rail and take the cue ball behind the seven and send the one ball up towards the nine, he'll probably get a good hook right there. Take the one ball, two rails, and then get the cue ball just with a little bit of draw and take it two rails behind the seven. Unless you're feeling froggy, and then go for it.
Yeah, he's not comfortable with this at all.
He's jacking up.
See? He's not comfortable at all with this.
He still wants to take it.
Yeah, I'll just get one later.
He's looking like he's shooting at this ball.
He's not comfortable at all with this.
He's still taking it, though. He's going forward, and he's putting the cue ball behind the nine. Not a bad way to go. You got the four and the nine as blockers. Six balls in the way.
That was a nice shot. That was well thought out.
Right. Can't even jump this. The six ball's in the way of the jump. He's got to come at least two rails to make a good hit. And straight in the corner.
He left him pretty tough. I mean, there's really...
Looks like Johnny's a little frustrated.
I mean, even if he would have hit it, he still would have left him a shot.
Yeah, you know, he's down in the match, and then all of a sudden he's got to come two rails just to get a good hit so he doesn't leave an open run out. And this still is a little funny with the three ball being right there. He doesn't have, like, clean position to the two. It looks like he's got to spin out two rails and play really good speed to get a full hit on the two. He doesn't look like he's going to draw because the six ball's in the way of coming up good on the two. It's still looking like he's going to draw one rail. Just hit it with a little bit of soft draw and then try to pull it back towards the left center table. And he didn't like the forward shape, so he came behind the ball, left himself long on the two, but in...
That worked out pretty good, actually.
Relatively full hit on the two, so he should be all right. You want to leave yourself on the left, or the, I'm sorry, the right side of the three, so you can pull back for the four. He's looking at that right now. He doesn't want to be straight in, because then he's going to leave a really hard angle on the four. So he's jacking up a little bit, and he just wants to kill this and slide it over to the right a little bit. Just like that. So he got on the rail, and he wanted to be able to draw this ball, so he's going to have to figure out something.
Yeah, it's going to be kind of tough getting on that four from here.
I mean, you can kind of like punch it and go off of the nine, but I don't know if he's going to be comfortable with that. He's going for it.
Yeah, looks like he feels comfortable with it.
Punches it off of the nine and causes a miss. But he's left Johnny half a ball at best and long angle.
That's frustrating, too, when you finally get to come to the table. Now you got to face this.
You're down in a match, man, and you know you play good. I mean, like, Johnny King, no matter who he's playing, is always kind of at least a local favorite. So he's wondering what the hell's going on right now. Even when you got a guy that takes a risky shot and they come out lucky anyway, it just, you got to come with a shot. And he came up too full. But he didn't get away with it. He's a little bit jacked up over the nine, but
yeah,
with a center ball punch, you can kind of just pull it off the rail and spin it out towards center table. Just center ball punch this with just a touch of draw, come one rail out towards the center of the table. Just making sure your angle's right. He likes the follow.
Worked out.
No, it's all bad. I mean, that's a makeable cut, but like he didn't really need to do that.
Yeah.
he was jacked up, so he felt better with the forward rolling position. But, you know, if you can't get enough juice on the ball, especially being jacked up, you got to worry about that.
It might even be worth it to bank that and bring it a rail back.
He's not going to bank that. If he's going for the ball, and he's going to play just a center ball and draw. Or he might. Oh, he's going to force it forward, a couple of rails.
Or he's going to go for the bank.
He liked that bank. That's good. I didn't know he was from Kentucky. Who says that? Freaking Danny.
You say that.
No. Freaking Danny DiLiberto.
Oh, that's right. No.
I didn't know he was from Kentucky. Just takes it straight back, gets good shape on the five, and it looks like maintains his composure. He should be out of this rack. Great match.
Yeah. I mean, this match could have went either way.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I mean? At any given time.
Oh, you know, like we were warming up with Chris earlier, and that guy couldn't miss a ball when he was warming up. And Johnny Kang also got to be a great match no matter what. Guy has a lot of heart. Just makes it happen.
But, he's more worried about position on the 7 than he is really trying to make the shot.
Well, he doesn't really want to have to stroke this ball, but he has to kind of put a little juice on it to get it off the rail and heading up towards the 7. See, what he's really worried about is he doesn't want to have to go two rails from the 7 to the 8. He'd rather just, like, stun it over for the 8 ball. But he's got to be able to follow through this ball and get it to head up a little bit up table for a good shot on the 7. The last thing he wants is to be far away from the 7 in an awkward angle because it's going to be tough shape. He's not going to cut that ball in the corner. Tell me he's not cutting that ball in the corner.
That's what he keeps looking at.
Really?
I mean, I would cross paint.
See, he's not comfortable with following through the side pocket. He doesn't like that shape. He wants to be able to move the cue ball more, so he's going to go two rails with top and try to come out a little bit towards the left side of center of the table for a shot on the 7. And how did he hit it? That's pretty much the shape he wanted. He wanted a little bit closer, but he still has full view of the cue ball, so he should be able to move it easily over for the 8 ball. Just got to stun it over with center ball. Oh, he stiffed it a little bit too much and came up short on the angle, so left Johnny a wide open shot. Johnny's probably going to take this in the side, come two rails out for the 8 ball and the 9 ball in the opposite corner.
Yep.
Or he's going to play the 9 ball in the same corner.
I'm going to go with the 9 ball in the same corner.
So now the score is Chris 7 to 6 with, is it Johnny on the break? So Johnny has a chance to tie this match up, which would force a hill-hill match with Chris breaking. Which you always want to see two really good competitors like this. You always want to see them go hill-hill.
Oh, absolutely.
You know, they both just play so good, and you don't want to discredit either one of them from being a contender at all.
You know what I love about Johnny, though, is when he's down, he gets you can tell he's mad.
Oh, yeah.
And that's when he's that's when you get his best game.
Well, it's like, it's hard to say a guy has emotion when, like, his happy face and his frustrated face and his angry face are all the same face. Unless he's laughing, and then he has a different face.
But I don't really see him laugh too often, unless he's got a few shots in him.
Well, yeah. He's the Heine Kang, you know?
The Heine Kang.
And look at that break. Looks like he's going to get...
Oh.
Oh, God. Oh, man.
Four balls on wait, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, 4 balls on the break and hooks himself.
How did
himself.
He hit that break? Good God, 4. He's gonna force a push out. He doesn't want to push.
Well, no. I mean, you just made 4 balls on the break. You hooked yourself.
You know, it just seems that way. It seems like the more balls you make on the break, the worse your position is on the upcoming ball.
You would think there's less balls on the table.
But you would think that way, but it just seldom works out that way. It's crazy. And, like, nobody coming up to the table is really going to like this cut. You're looking at pretty close to 90-degree cut. And this row of tables actually has fairly tight pockets. They look like 4-inch or 4 1/4-inch pockets. I don't know if anybody measured them or not, but it's a tight table. You never want to take a 90-degree cut like that, rail to rail. He's goes for the bank, and it comes up short. And he's left a long and funny position shot from the 1 to the 4, where you gotta, he's might play safe over here, see how he feels, and he plays safe. He's got blockers with the 5-9.
That was pretty.
He looks like he left a window, but I don't know if he can actually get through to that ball.
Maybe
it looks funny.
Come behind it, maybe.
Like, what you'd want to do in this situation, if you really could, is if you could see the side of the ball, get the ball up 2 rails and then try to freeze on either the 5 or the 9 if you have that much room. But he looks like he might even be kicking behind it.
Yeah, he kind of measured up behind it, so I think that's what he's doing.
Now you can see it, 2 rails, and tried to get it behind the 5 and left an open shot. So, Johnny maintains his composure, should be a hill-hill match.
And that's what we came to see.
That's what everybody wants to see. And with guys like this, you got to think, like, whoever has the break has the advantage. But also, being able to pull off a break and run hill-hill is a feature in its own. So, you'll see some nerves. Oh, and a miscue.
Like, she won't let me. She yelled at me.
A miscue, and it looks like Chris can see the whole ball.
No.
But,
I missed the miscue.
It, he looked like he kind of jabbed at the ball a little bit. And, forced a miscue.
Heart.
If,
it isn't
looks
break
like
Johnny's heart. He's,
no.
He just took a big swig of his Heineken. He's like, one way or another, I'm winning.
And that's how he thinks, man. And that's why he's always going to be a competitor to be reckoned with, man. Because when times are tough, like, he's gotten out of a lot of matches where he's even been down before. And it looks like he's going to pop this over in the bottom right corner and then spin around 3 rails with a little bit of inside and hopefully end up close to straight in. Oh, he's going to swing out. He's going to swing out 1 rail. See, I thought if he was feeling good about the shot, like, he should have just let the natural 3-rail
that's
shape.
That's the kind of stuff I've been missing all day.
Just, but if he just let it,
railing it like that.
Just let the shot go around the table naturally. As long as you're playing good speed, you shouldn't have to worry about pocketing the ball. And looks like you can just pop this forward a little bit. And looks like it's going to be a hill-hill match again.
That was just a perfect bomb.
Yeah.
I love how
he's a little mad. He's a little mad.
Hill, hill, everybody.
Hill, hill. All right, so Chris F. and Johnny K. go to the hill in an 8-8 race. And it looks like Chris is going to be breaking. And, you know, you're hoping for a break and run for Chris, but, you know, anything can happen, hill, hill. I've seen funny things.
Did you call him Jonakin?
Heineken. Check it out. There's the Heineken right there.
Tiny King.
Johnny the Heineken.
Jonakin.
God, they both play just so good.
And it's funny too, because I mean it's like the world caliber champions in here, Hall of Famers, but these are the matches I like to watch.
Right. You want to watch good pool, because you're going to pick up stuff. You're going to learn stuff by watching these guys play. And the more time you can get... Oh, and it looks like a dry break as we're talking.
I can't tell.
But
if
how much room does he really have? I think he can get through. He looks like he's going to make that one, too. He'll spin the shit in.
If he does, he should. I mean, it's an out if he can.
He loves these kind of shots.
Okay. Yeah.
So now the question is, does he set up for the 3-9 or does he come behind it? See, if he comes behind it, he's going to have the 8-ball to contend with. He's got an open way to get to the 3-9 combo coming across, but he's going to have to get behind the 8-ball for good shape from the 3 to the 4.
We got some professional commentary going on.
And for that, I am grateful.
Like, he looks like he wants to draw it back two rails behind the 8. But
what a match this turned out to be.
Yeah, in a hill-hill game, like, you never know what you really want to try. Might be a last shot.
By the way, folks, I just want to let you know not to go anywhere after this. We have a great match coming up after this from the one-loss side. Trace Kane from Arizona and Vilmos Foldis will be playing race to... whatever they play to. I think it's going to be a 9/8 race.
Whatever they play to.
But, you know, please don't go anywhere. This should be one for the books.
Exactly.
Trace is a very, very strong player. And, you know, I'm being told that Vilmos is not having the greatest day.
Just because Justin beat him doesn't mean that he's not having a good day.
I thought I was having a good day.
For all we know, Justin may have saved him. But that's neither here nor there. Don't go anywhere. There's another match happening right after this.
Man, how do you go from playing so good to...
like 3 shots? I don't know.
I don't know, man. It's so crazy.
He went for the 9.
And he went for the 9.
You know, see, that's what Johnny does, though.
What I was saying. It was actually really hard to be able to draw back with spin to get it behind the 8 for good enough shape to get from the 3 to the 4. That's a lot of stuff on your plate, and he didn't really leave a whole lot for Chris to work with.
No, he got.
Like the safe.
I don't want to say lucky, but I mean
the safe here is he wants to take the cue ball off of the right side of the 3, come one rail up, and then somehow get the 5 ball behind either the 8 or the 9 up table. Like, there's not really anything super aggressive you can go for unless you want to try just like a one rail in the cross corner. But I mean, that's a really risky shot hill. He might be able to play a slow roll off the right side of the 3 and then come one rail behind the 6, one or two rails behind the 6.
Yeah, Chris is stomped.
What do you think, dude? Like, just come off the right side of the 3 and then up one or two rails behind the 6 right there?
Again, I would go for the bank. I would try to bank it in the corner.
You would just fly that bank?
That's just me, though. I would. But maybe that's why I'm sitting here.
I mean, if you're Efren, you'd fly that bank, dude. No, that's no good.
No. He might have. No, he left it. He left it.
Well, I mean, this shot doesn't have to go in. But
no, it doesn't. But I mean,
it doesn't have to go in.
When you just did a comeback down from 3-7 to, you know,
man, how great would that be to just like slam this combo in, perfect shape on the 3, run out the rest of the rack. That would be a great out from Johnny Kang. And he hit it good.
Hit it perfect.
How did he hit it? So now the tricky part is going to be getting the right angle from the 5 to the 6 to drop back on the 7. He's looking at that right now. He wants to be almost straight into the 5. But be able to get the ball a little bit closer to the 6, a little bit on the right side like that.
If he could bring the 6, the cue ball all the way to the rail.
He basically just wants to stun it straight and then just drag the ball up pretty much where his tip is right now.
What do you drag the cue ball here?
If his tip was right there, he's just going to play a one rail back over to the other corner.
Because I'm thinking if he brings the cue ball here, he could use this.
That's not how he plays.
That's how I play.
No, if he can go one railing out, he's going to go one railing out. So you're going to see a big old stroke.
He's going to draw back.
Big old stroke, draw back one or two rails, possibly even three, depending on how much juice you get on it.
Oh.
And he got the one rail shape, but he missed the six ball. So he's going to leave Chris an opportunity to play something good. And that sounds like me. And that's me.
Well, Justin's got his match. So
thanks, everybody, for listening.
Let's wish him a good luck. Who are you playing? Jerry Lynn. Justin's going to be playing Jerry Lynn. Yeah, he made a really nice cut on that, but he hit it just a little too hard. Daniel's busy right now. He's good. How do you do that? He's good. Okay, well he left Johnny a pretty open shot on the seven. I think he's just kind of looking about where he's going to play the eight ball. That was nice. That was, what a comeback. What a comeback from Johnny. There it is. Johnny comes back to beat Chris. Chris was down three, or Johnny was down 3-7, raised to 8, and Johnny, what a match that was. That's all I'm going to say.
Well, that was back and forth, like, the whole way.
Well, Chris had him down.
Chris had a lead on him.
3-7.
Yeah.
Chris was on the hill. Johnny came back.
No, I don't think it was 3-7, was it?
It was 3-7.
Ouch. Ouch.
What about my ball head?
No, did Brian Katie take you down?
I took myself down, but Brian finished me off.
I saw you play that great bank on the 8, and you missed the easier bank on the 9.
Yeah, I came up short. I'm not supposed to have to bank that 9 ball.
I know.
I made a good out that out. I got perfect on the bank. And then,
you did?
It is what it is.
All right.
Need a little more work.
You'll be here tomorrow, right? Are you hanging out tonight for a while?
No, I'm going, and I got to bring back my my boys in the morning for 10 o'clock matches. So.
Yes, yes.
Okay.
We'll be here tomorrow
nice.
for her boys.
For my boys.
Who have winner's side matches, those lucky guys.
10 a.m.
All right.
Those,
tune in.
Those lucky guys.
Those boys would be.
So, Brooke, how do you share a bed with Efren and Boosty? Do you sleep
share.
In the middle?
No, I don't share.
Okay.
I get solo, and they do what they do.
Oh, all right.
Okay.
Whoa. POV pool after dark.
After dark.
Dark.
Where the truth comes out.
All right, guys. We're going to have another match shortly. In fact, it's Vilmos Foldis versus Trace Kane. Don't go anywhere. And if you do, make sure it's only to the microwave or to the refrigerator. Come back with snacks.
Come back with snacks and call it a late night.
Woo.